more level 5 for Tai Chi, or Deja training, basically. So, the small balls. So now we should have, if you remember, I'll just draw the guy here. So we got our Tai Chi guy. And he already had the 4 small balls. So these are like the size of your fist. And they're in the gua, okay? And they're under the armpits. And they're creating surface tension and compression and release. Now you add every joint gets small balls. So the knees, the ankles, all these major joints, and there's actually 2 on your neck as well. So what that does, again, is create compression and release. So if I've got the ball here, when my elbow retracts to my body, even though the power is compressing here, there's something in my mind that physiologically, because I've placed this there mentally, is pushing back outwards. So when I'm retreating from something, quote unquote retreating, not running away, retreating from some kind of power, there's always outward force going back at the opponent. Right? I'm never disappearing completely unless that is my actual attack. So if I add one of these into each place, what they do, not only do they do the compression and the release, but they start to support your stances in the legs. And the ball will roll to whichever side the joint is turning on. So a good example is my wrist, okay? Because I can move my wrist both upwards and downwards. So if I've got the ball here, it's hanging out, rolls around the wrist. If I do this to palm somebody, the ball is here, supporting this. But if I'm doing a gong style and I get here, the ball will roll to this side and support this. Okay, it's the same with the ankles. When we do like a snake creeps low type thing, normally, right, the ball is here because we do stuff like this. So I need the compression here to keep my, you know, running on the rails, still have power upwards, all that sort of stuff. But if I do something like snake creeps low, when I get down here, this ball will stay here, but this one, as the ankle opens, will roll underneath to hold me in place. Make sense? Because I can compress against the earth as much as I can compress against my own bones, right? So this is where rooting and all of that stuff starts to be a thing. Because as somebody touches me, all of this compression creates an outward surface tension. But it also creates an outward surface tension against the earth, right? So they push me, they push the ground is the idea. And the ground pushes back hard. Does that sort of make sense? And again, these are just mental images, right? They're visualizations, essentially, while practicing, so that physiologically we can make changes in our Tai Chi practice, in our Nei Jia practice. It doesn't really matter.